Good morning. I am Karthik Ravindra Kate and this is class on absorption loss. This is the continuation of UV visible spectroscopy. I told we prepare a sample. We take the molecule and we dissolve the molecule in appropriate solvent. And we make the solution and we are going to supply UV visible radiation to that. So, we should know some idea about absorption, how much radiation it has absorbed, that is nothing but absorption. There are two laws of absorption, one is Beer's law and the other one is Lambert's law. In this class, I am going to discuss both the laws. First, let us discuss about Beer's law, Beer's absorption law. The statement is, when a beam of monochromatic light is passed through a substance dissolved in non-absorbing medium, the absorption of light is directly proportional to the molar concentration of solution or substance, that is solute. When a beam of monochromatic radiation is passed through the substance, it is going to absorb. That absorption is directly proportional to the concentration of the molecule. What this statement means. So, we can write the same statement mathematically without using any words as log to the base 10 I naught upon I is directly proportional to the concentration of the substance. That is nothing but Beer's law. Here, what is I naught, what is I and what is C? I need to explain. C is nothing but the concentration of solute. I told we prepare the solution. See, here I have taken 1 liter of solvent. That is 95% of ethanol. I have taken 1 liter and I am going to add ethene because I am going to analyze ethene molecule. So I am going to add 10 grams of ethene to this solvent. What I do? I will take 10 grams of ethene. To that I will add little solvent and I am going to stir it and dissolve. And little solvent and once I will prepare a 1 liter of solution. And the concentration of this solution is 10 gram per liter. That is 10 gram per liter is the concentration of solution. Similarly, we can do concentration in terms of molarity. That is, they will say 5M, NaOH solution. That is 5 moles of NaOH is present in 1 liter of solution. That is nothing but 5M. Molarity, that is nothing but concentration, can be in terms of molarity, molality and gram per liter, many things. Percentage W by W, percentage by W by V, we have. This is nothing but log I naught upon I, that is the absorption. This whole term is nothing but absorption. Absorption is directly proportional to the concentration of substance in that solution. It is nothing but Beer's law. And now I need to explain about Lambert's law. Lambert's law. And it states that when a beam of light is passed through the substance, the absorption of light is proportional to the path length of the substance. What is path length? I need to explain. See, you please note it down. I am going to rub it and I am going to write the same this in terms of mathematics without any words. That is, they told the absorption, that is log to the base 10 I naught upon I is nothing but absorption is directly proportional to the path length, and I denoted the path length in terms of L. This is Lambert's law and Beer's law. If I combine them, I am going to get Beer's Lambert's law, and it states that log to the base 10 I naught upon I, that is absorption, is directly proportional to concentration of the substance and path length. So if I remove this proportionality constant by other constant, which is known as epsilon, molar extinction constant, and it is C by L. This is Beer's Lambert law. Now I need to explain the terms I naught, I, C, and yellow. It is very simple. See, what we do is, let me rub all these things and let me explain you clearly. See, what we do is, we take a solution here like this. This is made of quartz glass. Why it is called? Because it is not going to absorb UV radiation. Here, I am going to supply monochromatic radiations of I naught. I naught means intensity of the supplied radiation. Here is the solution of some concentration. C. The concentration of the solution is C. Here I have concentration of solution. And this intensity which I have supplied radiations, some radiations will be absorbed by this concentrated solution and will be emitted. That emitted radiation's intensity is nothing but I. So, we know absorption is nothing but I naught minus I. Isn't it? I naught, the supplied, and how much has been not absorbed by this is nothing but I naught. I naught upon I. If I take log I naught divided by nothing but this is absorption. Absorption is given by log to the base 10 I naught upon I. How much I have supplied, how much it has transmitted out, the remaining will be absorbed. That is nothing but this log to the base 10 I naught upon I. That is nothing but log I naught minus log I. That is nothing but absorption. And the length of this holder will be of 1 centimeter like this. And this is nothing but path length, which I denoted by L. So log I naught upon I is absorption is directly proportional to path length, that is L. And also it is going to be proportional to concentration. If concentration I increases, then the absorption will also increase. So it is also proportional to C and this is proportional to L. This is about absorption law, that is Beer's law and Lambert's law. Now I need to give the relation between absorption and transmission. I told absorption, how much radiation is absorbed is nothing but absorption. Transmitted, how much radiation will be transmitted out after absorption is nothing but transmittance. So absorption is inversely proportional to transmittance. That is, if absorption is more, then transmittance will be less. Why it is? Because both are inversely proportional. See, how can I explain it? I have supplied these four radiations and it is going to absorb, the molecule is going to absorb two radiations. It has absorbed two radiations. So output will be only two radiations. That is nothing but absorption. Here it is transmission, in absorption is two. As absorption increases, if it has increased to 3 radiations, then transmission will be decreased. It will be 1 radiation. In this way, absorption and transmitted are related. That is, both are inversely related. And in IR spectroscopy, as I told, we are going to plot a graph of percentage of transmittance versus wave number. It will be like this. Here we are going to have wave number and here percentage of transmission, and the graph will be like this. We are going to get, see here the percentage increases from 10%, here to 20%, like this. The percentage of transmission increases and it is 100%. If I consider this point, see, this is at 20%. It means percentage of transmission is 20. 20% is going out. Other 80% is absorbed by this molecule. That is nothing but relation between absorption and transmittance. See, the point A, the percentage of transmission is 20. If percentage transmission is 20, it means only 20% is going to be transmitted. Other 80% will be absorbed by the molecule. It is the meaning of this. See, if I consider this, see, it is around 90%. Let me call it as B. The peak B has 90% of transmission. Means 90% of radiation is transmitted out and only 10% is absorbed. That is nothing but relationship between absorption and transmission. Means 90% of radiations will be transmitted. All radiations will be transmitted. Only 10% will be absorbed by the substance. It is nothing but a point B and is of point A. And also I told you that I am going to explain you about nature of solvent. We are going to take a suitable solvent, I told. What is the nature of solvent? It depends upon two things. The solvent should not absorb any EV visible radiation. That is one condition. Because we are going to analyze the structure of a molecule, if solvent also absorbs the radiation, then what we record will be default. So it is going to be error. So the solvent should not absorb any kind of radiation. And the second condition for solvent is it should not be polar, so that the interaction between solute and solvent will be less. If solvent is less polar, then interaction between solute and solvent will be less. So there will not be any wrong or error in the analysis. If interaction is more, then the percentage of absorption and transmission, there will be error. So these two conditions are required for solvent, and this is all about absorption law. Beer's law, Lambert's law, Beer's Lambert's law, and relation between absorption and transmission. As I explained, the point A, what point A stands for? It has percentage of 20%. Only 20% of radiations are transmitted, other 80% are absorbed. So the relation between transmission and absorption is inverse. It is all about absorption law. In next classes, we shall discuss something new. Thank you.